Long since we've done a gig, so this could be interesting. Hey, I'm glad you can share with us. Let's do it. This one's called It's You.
Chess Burstone, Ross Wall.
Oh, yeah.
Hoi, hoi.
Yeah, hoi, hoi.
Yeah, that one's called It's You. That was released on Loud Cult.
Oh, yeah.
With Gok Turk, GK, TRK, and Alva.
Yes, I wonder if the boys are on tonight watching. If you
hopefully
are,
they're there.
Big love to you. Big love.
Who's on lock? Let's have a quick look.
Yeah, who we got here tonight? Who's watching?
Louise Aldridge. There she is. Matt Roberts. Yes, hey there, man. Hayley. Oh, it's kicking off. How are we doing on the YouTube front, Tommy?
We've got Orion Music Limited saying, sounding great.
Hey. Hey, hey.
And Michelle says, hi.
Hi, Michelle. Thanks
Pick
for tuning
yourself,
in.
Guys.
Are you ready for this one, Rossi? So this next song.
Okay. So you're probably going to recognize this next one. This is probably one of the most legendary sax house tunes ever. It's called Jude Bell by Klingander. I've literally flown all around the world playing this one, so thank you, Klingander, for making this track, because you basically gave me a job. Hope you like it.
Save me. You think I don't like, though, the things I don't like, so why are we losing time? To give up on, bring me what I need, so why are we losing time?
Hey. We got Do You Still Love Me. This is our first ever tune that we ever wrote together.
This was our first tune. This came out on the legendary Berlin house label Chill Out Tales, which is under the umbrella of Place Called Home.
Thank you, Place Called Home.
Big shout out to Carsten and Philip. Also, Carsten, check out his Summer House, Summer Feel Good playlist. Carsten's playlist is a crazy Spotify playlist for feeling good, for those driving summer vibes.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, this Let's one go. Goes a little bit like this.
Do you still love me? You still love me when I'm gone. It's taking me over. It's driving me crazy all night long. When there's no reply to my message, but I can see you've been texting. Do you still love me? Do you still love me when I'm gone? I don't mean to be like this. Need you, want you all the time, and I know it's a little bit much, but you are all that's on my mind. This is making me restless. How many times can I ask this? Do you still love me? Do you still love me when I'm gone? Do you still love me? Do you still love me? Do you still love me? Oh, 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 oh yeah. Do you still love me? Do you still love me when I'm gone? I know I'm getting caught up, but I just been in love with you so long. I know that I crave your attention, but you ghost to me when I mention. But do you still love me? Do you still love me when I'm gone? Hope that you understand it. This is not what I planned in. I know it's a little bit much, but you are all that's on my mind. This is making me restless. Times can I ask this? But do you still love me? Hey, do you still love me when I'm gone? Do you still love me? Do you still love me? Do you still love me? It's true, I can't do this without you. Supposed to do.
Oh man, that takes me back to the start of lockdown, you know?
Yeah, it really does. And I remember where I was when you sent me the track and I was listening to it on a dog walk. And I remember writing the lyric on a dog walk and I was thinking, oh my God, where's my voice recorder? I've got an idea. Came to me on a dog walk in the sunshine.
It's mad. I mean, you producers out there, Tess Burstow, and it's just a gift. I mean, you send her a musical idea and a top line comes back within about 12 minutes and it's just Premier League every single time. I mean, absolute hit writer
Thanks,
right
babe.
Here.
Can speak for himself.
Oh man,
amazing talent. Oh, it's a big tune next.
Big tune. I think we should say who's on Instagram. Let's have a quick hello to Instagram.
I'm going to have a look. Here we go. Matt's given us all the love. Yes, thanks, Matt. Tess and her dog walks. I left him a voice note on my dog walk today. It's a daily thing. It happens every day. We can't get away with it. Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Hey. Thanks for the wave. Hey, babes. Oh, yeah. We got lots of love on here. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, Gleaming Wings UK.
How you doing, Ian?
Hi, guys. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much for the love. Yes.
There you are. How are we doing on YouTube, Tommy?
We're doing really good, guys. Do you want me to run through some questions?
Yes, please.
We've got a couple of questions. So this is actually two questions in one. How did you meet and how long ago?
I think it was through this young man. I think it's all about you. Ross is like, oh.
I think Ross should answer that question.
How did you meet? Well, I actually introduced you to Tess. I actually introduced you to Tess because I said she's a fantastic vocalist and really professional. And look at you now.
So it's down to Ross Wall.
We did a gig and we did some promo videos pre-lockdown, pre-COVID times. And yeah, and it kind of grew from there. You messaged me, didn't you?
It was Babington House was the gig.
Yes.
It was Babington House.
Babington House.
I had the flu. This is pre-COVID. I had the worst bout of flu I've ever had in my entire life. I mean, I was bedbound for about 10 days. And Ross was like, bro, we got this gig. And I just about made it in time. And that's the first time I saw Tess and we worked together.
Oh, yeah, that's a good gig. It's a good one.
It's a great gig. Babington House is a beautiful venue, guys.
I miss those gigs. Hopefully soon, this summer. It's coming. We're coming back. So, big tune next. Yeah. This next one is by we are huge fans of Baker Matt. We've just signed to his label. We're super excited about that. And this next one is one of his big tunes, and it's been a massive, massive tune this summer. So I hope you all love it. This one's called Baby, and it's really, really high. So get ready for it. It's high. Here we go.
What a legend, Tess.
Love, oh, stop it. I love that song. Love doing that. Oh, I feel pumped now.
I've not got enough arms and legs here today. We needed a drummer. We was calling around frantically.
We were trying to find someone, but I think you're doing a great job.
I'm doing my best.
Isn't he doing a great job?
I'm trying.
He's so multi-talented.
I can't keep my leg perfectly in time, but I'm trying my best.
He's doing some singing on the next one as well, so. I just want to know. Yeah, we are. Give him a second, swap. I'm going to come and have a look over here and see who's online. Who's coming to see us? Oh, yay. Thanks for the love, guys. Yeah, baby. I'm glad you're enjoying it. Yeah, hi, Christopher. Thanks for joining. Thank you, Ugamush. I don't know how to say it. Ugamush. Thank you. loving it. This is so great.
Brendan, Test, mind if I jump in with a question?
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah. Have a quick drink.
So, before that last song, you were talking about COVID. So
yeah,
my question to you is, you both had to retrain during lockdown to pay the bills. How did you guys find that?
We're gonna go first. Go on.
Well, you can probably see I've got bitumen paint all over my hands, and if you've ever worked with
us, filthy.
No, I mean that stuff's like tar; it just sticks to you, you know. But I did a plumbing course, and I've been doing some building bits and pieces. And Tess is
I've just retrained as a personal trainer. I'm a PT now, fully qualified PT. Which is a bit random, but it's been amazing actually. It's been really good fun. It's just another one of those things that's come out of lockdown that's been really positive and really great. So anyone needs a PT, give me a holler.
Anyone needs a wall building?
I'm going to ask you for some plastering soon. I'm even joking.
I've done a lovely patio outside, if you could see it, guys. Beautiful.
Oh, yeah. He's a talented one, this one. He can do anything.
So this next track was out on Diep Graven Records. It's actually one of my favourite tracks. It's just such a vibey, summery, feel-good track. And we did this with Eros and Artix, two absolutely fantastic producers out in Spain.
We had so much fun on this one, didn't we?
So much
fun on
this one.
Our little group chat was so great. It was such a good time. When it signed, we were we had a party. So yeah, this one, Brendan's going to give us a little bit of vocal as well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Just thought I'd give you a little
reminder. Just a little taste, a little flavour.
This one's called I Just Want to Know.
Thank you.
one. Love stripping that one back.
It's funny, you have to sort of be your own audience when you're doing these live streams, you know. You got to give yourself...
I know, I make something in the club.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Just get back in my box.
It's madness.
Oh, it feels good to spread the wings again and have a little bit of a sing.
Music.
It's been a while. It's been a long time.
Right, so this next track came out on Be Yourself Music.
I was just going to jump in with a question, Brendan, but if
Tommy's, no, Tommy's jumping in with a question.
It's question time.
Sorry, folks. Yeah, it was just a quick one. Brendan, what made you get into music?
Do you know what? I was about 5 years old, and basically we went on this like holiday down to this place called St. Aldrey's Bay in Somerset, and... We loved it as kids. Like, we go there 1 week a year, and it was just mental. It was like this kids club and stuff, like all the stuff that completely repulses you when you become grown up. But when you're a kid, it just is amazing stuff. And I used to have this guy playing a saxophone in the evening. And I was just mesmerized. And I was sitting there one day, and this guy realized I was just mesmerized by the sax. And he got off the stage. He looked at me. He said, "One day," he said, "you're going to play saxophone just like me." And that was it. That one moment, I just came home and said, "Mum, I need sax."
Who was this guy? Does he know?
I don't even know who he is.
I wonder if he knows now. And he remembers. Yeah. And he's like, "I did that. I did that."
And that's literally it. That was that one.
Look
moment.
At you now.
Look at me now. I'm a builder. So, if you need paths or patios, guys,
he's good.
But yeah, what about you, Tess?
Me, my dad plays the piano, as always, and I always just sit on his lap and he'd play me. I'd make him play me all sorts of things. And my mum is musical family, and we've always loved it. And I actually started playing the piano, and then yeah, I fell in love with it. I went to see. I'm not telling everyone. I want to tell everyone this. I'll tell you. Screw it. So I went to see Phantom of the Opera when I was like 11, 12, and I was just obsessed. Obviously, I'm not turned into. I didn't go and do opera singing, but you know, I was just mesmerized by the voices, and I couldn't believe how magical it was, and that people could do this with their voices. And yeah, it became an absolute obsession, and I just put so much time and. My life just became about singing. My mum and dad used to drive me around to all my gigs. They used to ferry me around like a little taxi service when I was like 13, doing my first little gigs with my little PA. And yeah, it just kind of stemmed from there. And then I went into gig. I actually did musical theatre, and now I'm doing gig. Well, none of us are doing anything there now. I'm a PT. Yeah. Who knew? So yeah, that's what happened. Phantom of the Opera, of all things.
Yeah.
Didn't
Tess Burstone, just a legend. So I'm going to say it again.
We
heard it here first. I'll tell you what, Ross Wall, musical genius, absolute
actually,
G. I think we want to hear about Ross Wall. I think we want to hear just a couple of words from Ross Wall.
Why did you get into music, Ross?
Why did I get into music? Well, I love music, but I think the first time I got into music was just having a piano in the house and just kind of just getting up on it. I was only about 5 years old, just getting up and jumping on a piano. Just playing some random songs, and I really enjoyed it and got some lessons. Just took it from there, really. So it's just about being young and inspired.
Yes. And look at you now. It's a whiz.
Okay.
Thanks, Edward Rossi. Yes. We absolutely love this next one. It's so funky, and we couldn't believe when it came out. We knew there was a new song coming out by our absolute amazing Baker Matt. And we were like, I wonder what it's gonna be like. And when it came out, we were like, yes, let's do this on our live stream, it's amazing. So I hope you all enjoy it. It's funky. Oh.
And I just got to add, the crazy thing for us is that the week before on Be Yourself Records, we released our track, We Can Have It All, that you're gonna hear next. And then the following week on Be Yourself Records, Baker Matt released this absolute anthem. So.
Very exciting for us.
Let's go.
Can't be tame. The way you flicker like a cigarette flame. I want you heavy like a London rain. A booty rock rocking like a hurricane. You got that look in your eye. I take one look and I'm high. No, I'm exactly the type.
Would you mind if I took just one bite? You got that look in your eye. I take one look and I'm high. You acting so impolite. We've been together so nice. We acting so impolite. No, we gon' call it at night. I'll call the car if you like. Let me see you walk that walk. Let me walk that walk. Wanna see you walk that walk. Oh yeah. Baby, walk that walk. Ooh, boy, on the side. Forget it, lady, like a New York line. You know you're getting up and up and down. Would you mind if I don't just walk by? Let's go, let's go. We say
that's a tune.
How fun is
that?
That
is a monster of a tune.
Thanks for that one, Baker Matt. Oh, yeah.
Who've we got on lock? Let's have a little look and see. Nearly fell into the camera there, as you do.
I was going to say, did anyone notice?
Yeah,
we've
got the Stuart Hogarth crew there. Big up yourselves. Right, it's kicking off.
Oh.
Tommy, how are we doing on the YouTube?
We've got loads of people watching now. We've got Daisy 88 in with a question saying, how did Ross and Brendan meet?
Oh, hear a good story coming on.
That's a great question, Daisy. We met at uni. In fact, I threw my beard down my front as I heard the question. I mean, when we met at uni, but when we really properly met at uni, we was in the uni bar.
Oh yeah.
And it's all flooding back to Ross now. And you say we did a prank call. Ross did a prank call on me.
Yeah, I did a prank call on Brendan, and he found it really funny.
So basically, I'm sitting there. I'm a bit of a fresher, and I'm sitting at the table, and my phone's rang. And you know what it's like. You know, you're fresh at uni. Like you've got to set a bit of an impression. You've got to just kind of mark your territory a bit. You know. And, so I'm sitting there at the table, sitting around the table, and the phone goes. So I answer the phone, and this guy, a real deep voice, goes, "Hello." And hello.
Hello.
Hello, yeah, I got your number. I said, pardon? Did you, I got your number? Your number's on my girl's phone, mate. What's going on? I was like, what? Yeah? I said, your number's on my phone, mate. What's going on? So at this point, I've stood up. I've started, like, reacting, you know. I've started reacting. Yeah, I'm coming down your place. I'm going to get your kneecaps, bro. He's giving me all this, right? And I'm now reacting because I'm sitting around. People can hear it on the phone, like. And what I didn't realise, Ross has got a recorded message. It was like the days of the old Nokia 3210s, whatever they were. You could start to play your recorded messages. And it's just a recording with gaps in the right places. And I basically like a complete plonker. And everybody in the whole bar knew about this apart from me.
Aww.
And it was just love at first sight after that, really.
That is a good move. That's very funny. I think I'd be your best friend too after that. Because that's, yeah, it's hilarious. It's a bit mean, but it's hilarious.
Yeah.
I love that. Thanks for that question, Daisy. Was it a good one?
We've got a question for Tess.
Goodness.
Actually, Daisy said, not a question, but just Tess is fierce.
Love you. Thank you.
We've got a few more questions, but I'm going to wait until after the next track, so crack on, guys.
Tess should introduce this track. This is the big track.
So this is the big one. This is the one we've just released. This is We Can Have It All with our amazing label, Be Yourself Music. It's just been a whirlwind of a release, this one. They've been amazing every step of the way. All of the promo and everything, they've been absolutely incredible. It's an honour for us to be on the label and release this amazing tune. It's a summer vibes track, really, really good fun. I hope you've all been enjoying it. And hopefully it gets us ready for the summer. It was a little bit of a teaser this week, wasn't it? It was hot. I was in my bikini on Wednesday, and then what happened? Now I've got my big
coat
out.
It's going to be Ugg boots on Monday.
Yeah, Monday with the snow. What world do we live in now? I don't know. So, yeah, hopefully this will keep you there in that summer place, ready for the summer vibes. So I hope you enjoy this. This is We Can Have It All. Let's do it. Some hearts going up there. Thank you. Oh, I'm sad it's
done. I love that tune. I know it's our tune, but I do love that tune.
That was fun. That was really good fun.
Now, just before we do a few little questions, just put my sax down. Just because we're all a little bit South London, Kent / Essex crew. And as Frank and Felix would call us boomers, we love a bit of UK garage. Lord Adidas, there he is. What a legend. Cameron, good to see you. How are we doing on the YouTube front, Tommy?
Yeah, we got a couple of questions coming. Brendan, what is your dream collab?
Oh, it's actually a really easy question.
Yeah, I think both have the same answers because we've both been talking about it.
It's got to be the big man, Baker Matt.
We must be
freaking him out. He literally must be arranging some private security at the moment, you know.
I think he's actually scared of us. He's legit scared of us. No, we've been talking about this for a while, haven't we? We just love him. That's our.
I just think it's just so, like, all of his tracks are just musical and different. Like, just bring flavors, different angles every tune. You just don't know what to expect every time.
Especially with that new one as well. It's so different, like, to what he's done. Right. So I think that'd be really cool.
Nick on the vocals on that last track, killer top line. Woo. But I think we're going to do it with UK Garage, you know?
Is it garage time? It's garage time.
Always is. It's never not garage time.
Now, this one we kind of just thrown together. We thought we'd throw it on the end for a bit of fun. It's a bit of a jam. And he's getting his acoustic out. How talented is this man? I'll bring you flowers in the pouring rain. Living without you is driving me insane. I'll bring you flowers, I'll bring you there. The tears you cry, I'll drive them away. Imagine if I tell you that I need you, and imagine if I need you too, and all I want you to do with me, tell me that you feel safe. Imagine if I tell you that I need you, and imagine if we need you too, I may want you to, I know you should be in love with me.
Get this one on.
Oh yeah.
Ready for this one.
Let's go.
Yo. And this love is surreal. Gotta believe that, but love and I feel. Girl, you got to reveal that, may love the way you feel. May love my contact the way. We like a physical contact, because last night never would tell you, and I never would I lie. See my love running, they make me feel high. See my cold wine chilling on the eyes. Everything is gonna be alright, man. This one.
I'm in flowers and I'm pouring rain. Sing it. Living without you is driving me insane. I'll bring you flowers, I'll make it dead. The tears are dry.
Every freaking day, every freaking night, wanna freak you, girl, your body's so freaking tight. Every freaking day, every freaking night, wanna freak you, girl, your body's so freaking. Yo, chanani, 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 way. Chanani, 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 way. With a little bit of luck, we can make it through the night. With a little bit of luck,
we can make it through the night.
You know this one? Yeah. Last night, I made a big mistake. Now I'm sitting in my room like brandy. Taking time to contemplate. I've been such a fool lately. I can see my whole world changing. There's no need to live if I can't be with you. What if it was wrong? I'm sorry. I think we need to hear Rossi Wall on the mic.
Oh, Rossi Wall, he's up for it. Come on, boy. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Let's go.
Oh, my God.
Yo, I remember when I was at school, they cheated me like I was a fool. Punish me for trying. For me, I had maths when they had PE. Practice for my GCSE. I was told the rest was better than me in English. Everyone got C, not me. They gave me a G. To kick by all the bully, cut my head on the crown and grazed up my knee. Sent to school on every birthday, I was detention every Friday. I had to work when others could play, so I said, used to be a DJ, but no, I became a pianist.
Let's hear from Russell. One more round of flowers, I think.
One more round of flowers.
Okay. I bring you flowers in the pouring rain. Living without you is driving me. Singing it from the home. I bring you flowers, I'll make it there. The tears are dry, I'll cry them all away. Oh, hey, baby, always be. Baby, did I say, ooh? Oh, baby, baby, always be. Baby, always be. It's a UK thing, stuff that we bring. Get out the mind, let the journey begin. This is today. That honor we sing. On the mic with a ring ding ding. In the club with a bag of tricks. On the mic with a one song shift. On the mic got Brendan Mills, Ross Wall on the mic and a one sack ticks. What about this one?
When I saw you, girl, from across the room, you had your eyes on me. I had my eyes on you. We went to the bar for a Zambuca. When you took my.
Okay, let's go.
Ooh, yeah. Oh, baby. Oh,
We've got to finish on some garage every single time. Every single time.
That was a complete blag, just so you know. They're like, oh, we know.
It's a very tight squeeze in here.
Yeah.
We're managing. We're doing well. You can tell it's hard times because we're drinking Carling, you know. The days of American IPAs are long gone for us musicians. Apparently, Gareth has got a very, very good backlog, though, tucked away in his garage. So he's staying well hydrated, which is good. Tommy, we've got a few questions.
Yeah, we do. We've got a... In Michelle, she says, Tess has a beautiful voice and love that Brendan sang on, not the last song, the song before. Michelle also said, love Brendan's voice. And we had another question come in for you, Brendan. Brendan, you've played all over the world. What was the most stunning location?
Oof, that's a good question. You know what? Sri Lanka is pretty special. I've got to be honest with you. Sri Lanka is I've been there twice now. And my last gig before lockdown was in Sri Lanka. And it was just like paradise. I mean, if you haven't been to Sri Lanka, everything about it, it's like a picture postcard. The people are wonderful. The food's wonderful. The weather is just insane. The beaches are insane. It's just beautiful. And I was out there last February just performing at the most beautiful wedding. And actually when the whole family came out, and it's just, we had the most amazing time. Like, you're going out swimming, turtles are coming up. It's just like Sri Lanka is just it's just the most beautiful place. And I got on a plane and like, we're just living in this dream world. Like, it's just amazing. We got home and my good friend, Alan Cooper. In fact, Alan, if you're watching, aviation legend, love you, man. And Alan called me up, first phone call, and he said, Bren, he said, I don't know if you've seen what's going on, but I think you could be in a bit of trouble. I was like, what are you talking about? And he said, well, this coronavirus thing that was happening in China, it's going mental here. And I just had no idea, you know, and then all of a sudden back to reality. And that was my last gig, 14 months ago, you know.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's what a year we've all had. And it kind of feels like the light's at the end of the tunnel a little bit now. And that it's coming in time with spring, like it's like a feeling of hope, like it's all going to end soon. I really hope it does, because we're all ready to go. We're ready. We're so ready.
Come on.
100%. Definitely, guys. Well, as we are moving out of lockdown, a question for you both. Any advice for independent musicians looking to take the next step in their career? Any specific support ideas that have helped you?
Tess.
You can answer that. I'd say... just communication and keeping in contact with people, like-minded people who are passionate about the same thing. Because if I've learned anything in lockdown, it's that opening up communications with people, with amazingly talented people, has just opened so many doors for me anyway. And there are things that I'm doing now which I never would have done if it wasn't for lockdown. And I think coming out of lockdown, when we're able to get out into the world again, I think that's something that's so important. It's just connections, people you know, have people, surround yourself with people that do what you love, and keep on at those people, keep connecting and doing stuff with them. I'd say that's been a massive learning curve for me. It's having all these amazing people in my life, and we all build each other up, and we all love what we do. And yeah, I'd say that's the best advice I can give.
Great advice. And Brendan, how about yourself?
I mean, just to add to what Tess was saying, and before COVID, because there's always this kind of thing, like I think through school and all, like just this general narrative that music's not a proper job and you can't, you know, you need to go and get a proper job. Well, all three of us here before COVID have had, you know, 10 plus years of full-time music, great careers, meeting great people, traveling all around the world, you know, just having an amazing time and doing it. And we put COVID to one side because it's kind of just torn through us. But, you know, aspiring young musicians, you've just got to stick at it and you can have a great life. And
it's worth it. It's worth all of it.
There's nothing like it. So
we know more than ever now how much we need it in our lives. I think it's as good as told us that it's a part of who we are and it's a part of our identity. And it's so important. And it's something we seriously need back in our lives. And I think everyone, musician or non-musician, is feeling it at the moment and missing music, live music. And the sooner we can get out there and get performing again and start listening to music again, the better. Because
I mean, this is
soul food. Yeah. Soul food.
This is the closest we've come to live in 14 months, you know.
It'll do. It'll do for now. We love you. We're grateful for you. Thank you.
100%. No, great, guys. Now, Tess, a little bird tells me that you appeared In the Pink Floyd show, UK performing the notoriously difficult Pink Floyd vocal solo, the great big gig in the sky.
Yeah, great gig in the sky, yeah.
In theatres and stadiums across the world, including the performance to none other than 125,000 people.
Yeah.
At the Walsall Stadium supporting Sir Paul McCartney, no doubt.
Yes.
Now,
absolutely terrifying.
Well, on that note, what would be your dream gig in the future?
Tough question.
Baker Mass just locking down his security again, you know.
Right, that's it. We're on lockdown now. That's a really good question. Do you know what? To be performing my own music and have an audience loving it and singing it back to me, I see, you know, artists and stuff doing that, and I think that would be it for me. I think I'd just lose my mind. I think I'd just cry. If I was on a stage, a huge stage, and even a small stage, just to have people singing my music back to me. And knowing that it's moved them and it's done something for them, that would be everything to me. That's kind of where I aim. That's my goal.
We're going there, Tess.
This year, come on, open the festivals up. Let's get them going. Come on, we want to do it. That's, yeah, ultimately, it's just kind of big or small. It's my own music and touching people. Not physically, obviously. Especially not in these days. You don't want to do that. You get in big trouble these days for doing that.
That's great, guys. We've just got a quick fire round. I don't know if you want to say anything before we kind of wrap up. I've got a quick fire round, though.
Yeah,
let's
do our quick fire rounds.
Okay, quick fire round. You've both got to answer at the exact same time, okay? You ready?
Oh, God. Okay.
Ready? Quick fire round. Glastonbury or Coachella?
Glastonbury. Glastonbury. It's got to be Glastonbury. Sorry.
Acoustic or electric guitar?
Acoustic.
Yeah, acoustic. Ooh. Yeah, acoustic.
Acoustic for me.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Coffee. I would have said coffee anyway.
Ballad or upbeat?
Upbeat.
Oh, that's not fair.
Oh, caught you.
It's not fair. No.
Quick fire.
Ballad! To sing, it depends on my mood. I don't know, ballad.
I like a ballady upbeat. Like the a soul upbeat. From a ballad. With a beat.
And no, can't do it. Tried. Ballady beat. Failed.
What about Ross? Ballad or beat?
Definitely ballad, mate.
Yes.
He's such a romantic. He's such a romantic.
Oh, is that his album?
That's it, folks.
That's all my questions, guys. So over to you if you want to.
I think we should do a cover to finish, and then we'll shut down a cover. What should we do? What's one?
This is unplanned.
Let's do a ballad because these two romantics.
Oh, mate.
Like a ballad.
Let's do a ballad. Are there any requests? Should we see if anyone's got a request?
Has anyone got a request for a ballad?
Ballad? Jukebox? And what we got? Has anyone got any requests? Oh, thank you, Chloe. Hi, AD. You will make it happen. Yes, we will, AD. We're making it happen this year. It's happening. Come on, guys. Any requests for us? Anything you want. Doesn't have to be a ballad. Upbeat. Anything you want. What do you want to see us do?
Let's do.
Oh my God. My voice like this. And, we're putting us on the spot now. What do we do?
There's your keys, I've got you. Oh, yeah.
Oh my God, I haven't done that in a long time. When you put us on the spot after a year of no gigs. Okay. Thanks for filling in for me, man. Let's see if my brain remembers it.
Some people live for the fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think it's a physical thing defines what's within. I've been there before, and that life
It in the end. It's amazing what we can do after a year. Cool. Oh, I think that's it, isn't it? That's it. Oh, it's a wrap. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in tonight. It's so good to do music again, isn't it? It's just so good to perform again. And I'm rambling because I don't want it to be over.
Right, guys, we're going to go need some pizza.
Ramble. We're going to have pizza now.
We're going to go and dent my beer fridge.
Oh, we've got 1,000 years. Oh, could we do a little bit of 1,000 years?
I'll do a quick 1,000 years.
Before we finish, because we got a little request from Chloe.
Come on then, 1,000 years.
Oh, two people have requested that. Okay, just a little bit of that, because that is an amazing song. Words. I've got no signal in here. I'll make it up. That one. I'm really sorry about the lyrics. I wasn't prepared. I just made that up. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you for having us. And we really don't want it to end, but that is all from us tonight. Thank you for tuning in, everyone that's here. We're sending all the love and safety to you all in these times. And I really hope we see you all at a gig real soon. So thank you and love to you all. Big love to you all. Thank you so much.
Everything that Tess just said, big up yourselves. Have a great weekend. Fingers crossed we get a bit of sunshine before Monday.
Come on.
Have a great evening, guys. We're going to eat some pizza. Big up, big love.
Hold love you guys.
Bye-bye.